As you can see here, we just got done with our first portion of the work, and so it's on 2 now, 2 out of 11. Yeah, so, and that's gonna be for the rayon. And so we just stop, and the machine just stopped. We changed our thread already. We put in the rayon, and so yeah, I'm gonna be moving on now. Let me see if I can get a glimpse of. Let you see what we got here. Okay, this is what we got for the first portion. That's her hair. That's the hair part of the nurse. That's her hair. We got a bun of hair there already. We use the dark brown for that instead of the color that they offer. I just went ahead and used the dark brown, and to me, it looks beautiful. So, yeah, we're gonna continue with the second portion of our stitching. So it's already ready to go. We're just gonna go ahead and just push this button. And you see, it already started. Can see here, it's doing the hand. That's gonna go for about 6 minutes. I'm just using, this is just Canva I'm using here. And I got my interfacing in there. Actually using a the cut out one. I'm not using tear away. I'm using cut away instead of tear away. So we're gonna have to cut that after everything. And if you can see under here, I don't know if you can see what I'm testing out something. So I'm using, I actually want that extra layer there, and so I try to add some color. Doesn't look too, it's not turning out too good to me. I might have to, yeah, the next one I might use a different color for the skin. Anyway, let's see what it looks like. So the second part is done stitching. We'll move on to number three, if you can see here. Oh, please, if you can just sit. I wish my camera would just focus. Okay, so we'll move on to number three already. Yes, this it's time to change our thread. We already stopped to change the thread for 058, but I don't think I'm gonna go with that. I'm just gonna go ahead and continue with the dark brown that I use on her hair, because yeah, I think I'll prefer going with that. Then the it looks more like olive green. Let's just say 58 embroidery. But yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and use the same dark brown I use on her hair. If you can see here, I just think it's gonna look better there. Then yeah, so that was our part two, number two of the stitches. We got 11 to go. So yeah, that was part two. We're just gonna go ahead now and change the thread from this to back to dark brown. So we just went ahead and loaded back our dark brown thread, and we're just going to start
in the back hello.
We're going to start on our the third session of our stitching. So
why do you do that?
So we went ahead and used the dark brown to do the highlighting of her face, and as you can see, this is how it turned out. And now it stopped, so we're gonna move on and change our thread again. This time I think it's for the face mask. Yeah, so we're gonna go ahead and change our thread to the rayon. I think I'm gonna use this one, 19. I'm gonna be using 19 from my thread box. That's what I'm gonna be using. If this thing could focus. Yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and use the 19 for that. Cause sometimes you can't actually have the all the colors that's in the pattern, but I mean, you can choose. You don't have to go by the colors that they give. You can decide to use what you want to use. So we change our thread. We change our thread to move on to the fourth part of the stitching. As you can see, it's 4 out of 11 now. So yeah, we're going ahead. Gradually we're trying this, but yeah, I don't know if you noticed, we did not so I didn't put the entire fabric in. I'm just doing what they call floating. I'm trying to float it. I want to see how it's going to turn out. So yeah, let's just go ahead and see whatever it becomes. It's part of the learning process. We're learning this, so yeah, don't be afraid to make mistakes, because you learn from every mistake you make. So I don't be afraid when I make mistakes, because I learn from it. So yeah, I'm never afraid to try new things too. I keep trying, and as you go along you figure out. So let's go. Oh, we forgot to lower the presser foot. Yep, so yeah, we learned that now. Always remember to lower the presser foot. Okay. I'm just gonna go ahead and grab my embroidery scissors. You can see here. I'm just gonna grab it now and clip that extra blue thread that we got hanging over there. I'm just gonna clip it so it don't get messy over there.
So I think the next one I'm gonna use black for the liner. As you can see, so that dark brown that I use, it made for eyebrows and eyelashes to be brown, and the back of her neck. Oh, awesome. My camera set, let it focus so you can see what we have here. Well, I think it's turning out pretty good. So now we're gonna move on to the fifth portion of it. We'll have to change the thread again and continue. So this time around, you can see we printed. So we printed our button in 5. So let me see what's showing up here right now. Okay, so I think this is gonna be for her max, number 5. Let's see 5 on our list here. Okay, bright white. Yeah, so you see, yeah, it's showing white for the thread. Yep, number five. So we're gonna go ahead and just change our thread now and go on to the fifth portion of stitching. I think that's gonna be like for the elastic on her. Nice if you can see where the cursor is right now. That little plus sign arrow, plus sign. Yeah, I think that's what the white is gonna be for. And I'm also just gonna go ahead and use the same white for her hair cap. I'm not gonna change anything over there. So, yeah.
We'll cut that thread and we'll start back. See, it resumed from right where we left it. So it's advisable to pause before you cut that thread. Don't let it be going and cutting. Okay, we're done here. We'll move on to seven now. I think seven is hot scrap, like the top. Yeah, seven is the scrap. We changed the thread again, this time for hot scrap. So we're just gonna go ahead now and start. And let's keep going again. So after a few stitches, you want to pause your sewing and cut that extra thread over there so it don't get messy, because sometimes it gets really messy and then digging it out and all that causes more problems. So it's advisable if you just pause and cut it after a few stitches. You see it under here, it's already, yep. So let's get it out. So this is just it's a praying nurse. Actually, I was looking for a gift for my mother-in-law. It's almost Christmas, and I mean, I just thought what would be more meaningful to her. She's a nurse, she's an LPN, and she's also a pastor. So I just went ahead. I was actually on Etsy trying to find somebody to do something for me, and then I just decided, I said, you know, let me just type it and see if I can find a photo of it or if somebody already has a pattern. So I just went ahead and checked for the praying nurse on Etsy, and sure, somebody had it. So the first thing I saw, a couple of other ones, just the nurses, and I like them, but not as much as I fell in love with this one, because it actually just means everything. She's a nurse and she's a pastor, so I just fell for it when I saw it. Like, oh no, even though it was kind of tough getting the payment done, because this person's shop only takes PayPal, so I had to go set up a PayPal account and all that. Yeah, but I mean, I just thought I had to get it because it just suits what I wanted for her. And I mean, yeah, so I hope she will like it. So I got it for her anyway. I'm trying to make her a keychain. I only have black marine vinyl right now, so I thought to use this Canva, and let me see how well it's gonna come up. If not, I might just drive on to Marcos, because my look man nearby Joanne just had a black marine van. Right now they're going on a lot of stuff. So if I'm gonna check there again, if this doesn't look too good, I might go to get the marine vanner in a lighter color. Maybe if I can get white or the same, some looking like more like the canva that I'm using here, I might just get it. But I think it's coming up. It's looking pretty good on the vanner though. I don't know how the edges are gonna look, cause yeah, but let's do this and see what it looks like in here. We'll decide what to do after cutting it, we'll see what it looks like. I got some fridge and fridge check. I got some from Joanne's Fabric, so yeah, gonna use that around it. Let's see what it looks like first. But so far the stitches, I think the stitches are turning up pretty good. I don't see anything like jumping or anything showing from the bottom yet, so I think that's pretty good. I used two different blues, like three rather, but seem like two of them looking more the same. I use number 7 and right now I don't remember the one I'm using right now, but it looks more like the 7 that line up her face mask over there. It looks more, the both of them look like, yeah, I think it's looking the same. Okay, so we gotta change again. This time around we're changing to, I'm gonna be using silver for the gloves. Yeah, so I'm just gonna go ahead now and just change my thread to the silver. I'm gonna be using silver for her gloves. Time to do the gloves. So got a gray thread on, silver thread on now. So we're gonna start. Up, yeah. Lower your presser foot. Okay, so I'm gonna pause it right there to cut my extra thread. This one you can barely see it because it's almost the same color of the canva we're using. So, okay. I don't know. I'm starting to have doubt about this showing on the fabric because of the color. So if you look here, that's something I forgot to mention. I want my camera to focus. If you look in the upper left hand corner of our design, in the hoop, we're gonna see, oh man, that looks too close over there. In the hoop, we can see there's something red and blue over there. It's just the snap tap for the keychain. So you're gonna have to purchase that extra. We had to buy that from another shop, but yeah, it's just a couple of dollars. You can buy that and download it too, so you can. I bought the two designs and then I merged them. Actually, I used in brilliance essential. That's the package I have, so I merged my designs in there to be able to get this as one design for the keychain. So yeah, you're gonna have to buy that extra. Or if you don't want to buy that, you can just go ahead and use the tool that you have to punch the hole in the keychain. You can just use that and punch a hole in there and just add your key holder to there. You know, we're all about saving money, right? So I just like to show people many different ways to kill a cat. Sorry to you cat lovers, it's just a saying. Is annoying. It's actually so loud, but the results afterwards is pretty, so I don't mind being in the noise. I'm used to it now. I can sit here all day and do this. Just the fact that the after the doing this, it looks more like olive green, but I'm not gonna be using olive, I'm using black for that. So I'm gonna pause this and cut that thread because I don't want that extra thread. Restart. I'm just gonna keep holding it down here so it don't go bouncing again. Thank you. So it stopped right over there. It's done doing the lining, the highlighting part of it. And so we're going on now to the snap tab. As you can see, I hope this thing can focus. Please focus, 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 please. As you can see, it's just, yeah, the red over there is showing now. That's what we're going to. So it's requesting to change the thread, but I'm not going to change it. I'm just going to go ahead and use black over there because I just want that entire thing to be black. So I'm just going to leave the black thread and continue. So the same black thread that did the highlighting on her shirt, on her scrub, I'm just going to leave it in and just go ahead and press sort. And again, it's time to do the inner part, that inner circle. So I'm just gonna go ahead and use the same black thread. I was about to hit the wrong thing. Okay, so let's say it's finished. We're gonna hook it up. And let's see what we have here. So we went ahead and removed our hoop from the machine, and as you can see here, this is what we got. That's our prey nurse. And if you have your snap, which I don't have here right now, you can go ahead when you're done adding the back. So to add a back to this, I don't really think I'm going to be using this one for her. I'm just going to have this as a sample. I have some black marine vinyl here that I'm going to be adding to that. I'm going to use the black marine vinyl on the back to cover this up. Yeah, so I might use that and use some heat and bond to put it on, since this design does not have the satin stitch, the border stitch. I'm gonna use heat and bond to keep it on, and maybe I can add some satin stitch from my sewing machine. But this is what it looks like. So if you're gonna use this, you're gonna have to cover the back, or I mean, if you're using it for patch, as a patch, you can just cut it and sew it on, or use heat and bond to put it onto your shirt or onto your cap. But since we intend to use this as a key chain, as you can see, we added the loop here for the key chain, so we're gonna have to add cover here on the back, which is gonna be vinyl. Sometimes you can use felt if you want to. I've seen some people use just felt on the back. Felt, I got some felt here, but I'm not sure whether I want to use felt on it. I'll think about it. But you can use felt, you can use marine vinyl or whatever, just to cover that if you're using it as keychain. But if you're going to use it as a patch, then you don't have to worry about all that, because this is not going to be showing. It's going to be attached do. This will be face down on your either your cap or your shirt or whatever you're using it on. So then you don't have to worry about covering that. So yeah, this is what we got out of there. And if you want to try it, you can go ahead and try it. I'm gonna leave the link to the shop down in the description where we bought the design. So in case you want to try it, you can go ahead and try it. But I think it came up pretty well, because as we can see, let me try to bring it closer. There's no stitches popping out or anything. Everything just, yeah, it came out real good. So I think it's awesome. Is that next time, so when I'm doing the one for her, I'm gonna just use the black to do all the lineup. Yeah, like you see the eyebrow, since I use brown so it made the eyebrow dark brown. But next time I'm just gonna go ahead and use the black to do all the lineups instead of using brown. I'll just use the black and just continue the lineup over there. And yeah,